As Kashish Gupta finds out, the ground reality in UP is quite different. 50% of the schools only have one teacher.
Barely 30 kilometers from the state capital, a school with 100 students under 10 being taught by just one teacher. So when the teacher is in one class, the others fend for themselves. The Right to Education, one hopes, will change all this. Currently, only 60% in Uttar Pradesh have access to elementary education. And of these, 40% drop out because of poverty. More than 85% girl children in the state don't even get primary education. 50% schools in the state have just one teacher. No surprise then that Mayawati's detractors have been vocal about her reluctance to implement the act.
Well, Mayawati has only money for her statutes.
Agar Mayawati ji ko lagta hai ki hum is yojna ko lagu nahi kar sakte is act ko kanoon ko mazboot karna chahiye to wo pad chhod de hum chala kar dikha denge.
Her voters too aren't impressed. Under the shadow of a 1,000 crore memorial lies this Dalit Basti. With no government school nearby, many children here stay at home.
उनके पास पैसा है जरूर, लेकिन क्या है कि पारी बनाने के लिए, मूर्तियां बनाने के लिए गरीब बच्चे क्या करेंगे?
जब वो स्कूल की शिक्षा के लिए नहीं है तो ये फजूल में पार्क बनवाने से क्या फायदा?
हम लोग के लिए क्या समझाऊंगी जो हम लोग दोबारा से फिर उनको तो नहीं देंगे.
Given her ongoing battle with the Congress at the center, Mayawati's claims that she has no funds to provide free education to children up to 14 years of age perhaps comes as no real surprise. But given that the largest number of beneficiaries of this Right to Education Act are likely to be from her community, Mayawati may just have miscalculated the cost of a political move this time around. From the Dalit Basti in Baluwadda in Lucknow, with camera person Rajesh Gupta, Kashish for NDTV.